Hello everyone. Apologies for this delay. Good afternoon, and my name is Moon. I'm a creator of Apache Zeppelin, and I'd like to talk about Apache Zeppelin and Helium framework on top of it, and as well as a roadmap. So I'd like to ask you, how many of you are heard about Apache Zeppelin? Oh, thank you. And how many of you are using Zeppelin? Okay, I think it's great. I think before I go to the Helium, I guess not many people know or heard about the Helium. So before I deep into the Helium, I can go through Zeppelin and the idea, basic idea behind the Helium framework. So if I start from the Zeppelin, Zeppelin is an open source software. Now it's under Apache incubator. And actually, Zeppelin was before the Zeppelin. In my company, I was building a data analytics platform that looked like this one. This, you know, dark user interface, and it wasn't that successful commercially. But one of its menu, it's got a lot of different menu, but one of its menu called analytics, which is interactive analytics menu, was kind of popular among few customers. So we decided to open source this single menu. That became a Zeppelin project. And then a year later, we got Apache incubated. And now we have a total 110 contributors worldwide. And we have more than 1,000 stars on our GitHub repository. And we have made 3 releases. And now, literally now, we are community is voting to the graduate to the top level project, Apache project. So I think Apache Zeppelin is one of the most popular projects in Apache Software Foundation, like many other Apache software project. Zeppelin is basically a web-based notebook that helps your data analytics. It's interactive notebook with nice visualization and many different backend support. So here is some screenshots. So as you see, you can create a lot of nice visualization over your data in interactive way. So I think it's more effective to see actual Zeppelin instance than this, static screenshot. So I was actually trying to demo with my laptop, but my laptop have some connectivity issue. I'm very sorry. So I think I can do some. I can use live demo site, but I'm not sure it's going to work. But let me try. So. Here is a demo. Yeah, this is how Zeppelin look like. Zeppelin have a few menus here, notebook, interpreter, and configuration. And I just created a new notebook called demo. And what I can do here is I can just put any code I want and run. Oh, it's not working. Okay, let me try again. Maybe. Okay, I think this instance is not really working. I think this instance is not working, so I guess we can, I can just imagine there is an output. So first thing you can do here is Zeppelin supports many different backend systems. So if you go to the interpreter menu, then you will see a lot of different backend systems that you can select. It includes Spark and PySpark, Spark R and Hive, Flink, and many other popular backend. And then inside of a notebook, you can choose the backend system that you want. And notebook is a consist of many multiple paragraph. And this one is one paragraph, and this one is the other paragraph. I think I can go to the other notebook. Yeah. Here is a code, and if I write some code inside of notebook, then I get a result. And I can mix different backend inside in the same notebook. So first paragraph here is a Scala code, and the next one is a Spark SQL. And I can actually mix many different languages inside of a single notebook. And you can see this one, this nice visualization here. So if Zeppelin detects your output is in output is formatted in a specific format, then Zeppelin automatically converts your output to this visualization. So Zeppelin have a few built-in visualizations, and you can actually select and play around it. And built-in visualization also have some nice pivot functions. So you can play around your data with this pivot table functions. And as you see, you can also change the layout. So once you have changed your layout and you hide your some of the code and change your theme, then it becomes nice dashboard, like nice dashboard or reports that you can directly share to your team. So basic idea of Zeppelin is you do interactive analysis with your favorite backend, with your favorite language, and you can explore the data, and you can do some work on notebook, and it becomes the reports directly, or the reports or dashboards directly from your work, without converting or without exporting your data. So it's pretty simple. Oh, this notebook seems to work. I think I can use this one. Okay, I hope this works. And if I go back to the slide, okay, so as you see, Zeppelin supports many different backend. Now we have more than 20 different backend system support officially, and unofficially there are many more third-party backend. And by the way, Zeppelin's term of backend is interpreter. So interpreter is Zeppelin's backend integration. And it's pluggable. So if you have your own implementation of interpreter, then without recompiling or rebuilding, repackaging Zeppelin, you can just drop your interpreter library into Zeppelin folder, and then Zeppelin will automatically you can use it. And one of the reasons that Zeppelin have a lot of interpreter is it implementing your own interpreter is really easy, really easy. So this is the interpreter class that you need to extend to implement your own interpreter. So basically, you have to implement three very basic methods: open, close, interpret. And I think without any comment, you already understand what it, you know, what those methods do. And optionally, if you wanted to have a more advanced feature, then you can implement cancel, get progress, and completion. So if you implement cancel, then you can cancel your work through the Zeppelin user interface. User interface provide cancel button. And if you implement get progress, then user interface will display a nice progress bar. And if you implement completion, then user interface will suggest auto completion. And there are two advanced methods that you can optionally implement. And Zeppelin, another pluggable part of Zeppelin is a notebook repository. So one of the pluggable component of Zeppelin was the interpreter, and the other one is a notebook repository. So notebook repository is where your notebook is saved. So by default, Zeppelin saves notebook in its local file system through common VFS library. And you can choose many different notebook repository, and you can even combine, or you can even use more than two notebook repository at the same time. Then Zeppelin will replicate your notebook to multiple different notebook repository. So now in Zeppelin source tree, we have four different notebook repository implementation. One is Apache Common VFS. It's basically for supporting local file system. And the other one is Git repository. And another two is S3 and Azure storage. So, and extending notebook repository is also really, really easy. So to make your own notebook repository, basically what you need to do is implement five different methods. So list your notebook and get your notebook, save, remove, and checkpoint. Checkpoint and close is optional, so you can just skip it. But if you implement checkpoint, that then Zeppelin user interface have a checkpoint button, and user can make a checkpoint, and you can manage your notebook version in this way. So the next one is visualization. So Zeppelin have six built-in visualization, as you saw. And there are actually many different ways to visualize your data, except for six built-in visualization. So let me go to this Zeppelin instance. I hope this works. Yeah, I think it works. So if I think I can look more into the Zeppelin now. So one thing is basically you write a code and you get a result. But there are many other things that Zeppelin helps your data analytics. For example, let's see this code. So this is a simple Spark SQL query. Yeah, and it's the data is bank data. The customer of a bank, each customer have their age and their balance in their account and job and some information. And I just run query that count customers by age, group by age. And when I share this report, then yeah, mostly I work, data scientists work, and they share this report to their business people, the other part of the company. And then they will really like this one, but they will immediately call you that, can you change the numbers? So I can change the number. For example, the business guys ask me, can you filter the age more than 40, for example? Then I can put this filter. Then I get result. And but business guy will ask again, so I can keep updating my query, but instead of I repeat my job, I can just put, I can create a dynamic form here. So if I put this format here, then Zeppelin automatically create a form here. Then I don't need to update the notebook, but user can update themselves using this form. So this is one of the basic usage of Zeppelin. And yeah, another one is Zeppelin only have six different visualization built in, but it's not limited to only six. If you want, you can draw any visualization inside of Zeppelin notebook. This is some example of chart using HiChart library, which is not included in Zeppelin, by the way. And you can just draw JavaScript functions, or you can run any HTML and JavaScript code inside of Zeppelin. So you can draw this nice chart inside. Another one, I don't have the example in this instance, but yeah, this is another nice example. This is another type of visualization that renders this image on back-end side and bring the results into the front-end side and display as an image. And this is another example. So Zeppelin have many different ways to visualize your data. And actually, I have more example that visualizing with matplotlib and using ggplot. But I think anyone interested in more visualization, then you can come after this talk. I can share. So I think I can go to the Helium. So. Helium is a platform for data analytics application on top of Zeppelin. So as you now see, Zeppelin have two different pluggable component. So interpreter is one pluggable component inside of Zeppelin, and notebook storage is another component of another pluggable component inside of Zeppelin. And we know Zeppelin have a built-in visualization, but it's not pluggable. So it really makes sense to make visualization pluggable too. So this is how Helium look like. Visualization, we wanted to initially make visualization pluggable, but Zeppelin can do much more than that. Zeppelin actually have capability to let your front-end code to interact your back-end side code. So not only visualization pluggable, but also we can make actual application layer on top of it. And that application layer can leverage the resources provided by interpreters. For example, Spark context can be a resource, or JDBC connection can be another resource that application can use. Unfortunately, this instance doesn't have a Helium Helium framework, so I think I can demonstrate some alternative way. Okay, I think I can start from the display system. I think I didn't explain in very detail about the display system, but let me, oh, this is too small. So let me go through step by step. So first thing is when you run some code, you will be able to select interpreters with this percent sign. So I'm selecting shell interpreter, and then I can let my shell command run. For example, who am I? Yeah. And I can print some text here. Hello, Dublin.
So anybody who can access this web interface can run commands as root.
Yes, that's true. So please, please don't remove too many things here. Yeah. And actually, we reset every 1 hour. In this instance, is reset every 1 hour, but just in case. So by default, every output is displayed as a text, but there is a, you can format your, you can define how your output be this wanted to be displayed. So by default, it's a just printed as a text. So even if you put some HTML tag here, you it's just printing as a text. But Zeppelin have something called display system. So you can select HTML display system in this way. So in beginning of your output, you can select your display system that you want to use. For example, text is selected in this way, and if I want to use HTML, then Zeppelin will use HTML display system to format your data. And it's independent from the backend side code. So even if I use Spark, for example, then I can do the same. So selecting backend is starting your code in with a percent sign, and selecting the front-end side, how you want it to format your data, is a similar way. One of the funny thing is built-in visualization is actually one of the display system that we have. So I can, for example, if I print my data in this way, like a table-like format, and then I can just put a table display system in front of my output, then Zeppelin automatically format this data and run this built-in visualization. So visualization is independent from the backend side code, backend interpreters.
So it would be possible to create a cron job in Zeppelin to run a Spark job?
I think there are a couple of possible ways. Zeppelin actually have a cron scheduler inside, so you can just use this one. For example, if I wanted to run my notebook every 1 hour, then I can use this one.
If I want to run just one paragraph of it on a repeated basis, not just the whole setup?
Yeah, that's a good question. So right now, Zeppelin, the only way is you create a new notebook and put your only paragraph in that notebook. Okay. So I think we can go some of the advanced feature of the Zeppelin here. So we saw this HTML display system, and we can go to some nice, some funny things here. Zeppelin also have a display system called Angular. There is a some display system called Angular, and we can you can print Angular view template inside of a Zeppelin notebook. And then what you can do is you can bind your view template and backend side value in. So Angular bind. For example, I just created a binding over this variable called name, and I put a world as a value here. And if I change this value, for example, then it immediately update the front-end side value too. And this binding works the other way around too. If you update this value from the front-end side, that means JavaScript, then the value propagated to the back-end side code, and you can get the updated value. And not only this updated, not only the value, but also you can actually catch the event from the front-end side. So you can create buttons, and you can put some event handler. And when user click a button, then you can run some code in your back-end side. So in that way, we can create some codes that interact codes that interact your front-end and back-end side codes that enables you create rich application on top of Zeppelin. Okay. So eventually what I really wanted to talk about is how this application framework will work. So instead of demonstrating Helium actually working in Helium, I think you can get some basic idea that how the Helium technology will work in underneath. So this Angular display system will be one of the building block of the Helium framework. So Helium framework will work with this Angular display system, so you can create your own user interface to interact with your backend side code. And how Helium works is I think this slide is better. So Zeppelin interpreter, I need to go back to the interpreter. So interpreter is a backend integration of Zeppelin, and its interpreter instance is run as a separate process. So when I run one interpreter instance, then there is one process created. So to leverage resources that provided by interpreter, Helium application need to go to that process, and Helium application need to run on that process, not Zeppelin server daemon. So Helium application actual code will run on the interpreter process, but the view, the front-end side code will run on your browser, and Zeppelin server will let this backend and front-end communicate. This is a simple interface how you can create a Helium application. Similar to your interpreter and notebook storage, you just need to extend this one single class, constructor and run and unload. This is really simple three methods is all you need to implement to make Helium application. And at this part, I need to demonstrate a Helium application, how you can create. But I have a, I think I have a backup slide here. So this is an actual code of one of the simplest example of a Helium application. This is this application get a date, and it just display the date with it. This, you know, simple date format here. So really simple application that just implement this constructor and run functions. And another one is this interpreter write clock.html resources. So this Java file, clock.java, is where your backend side code is placed. And the clock.html is where your front-end side code be placed. So it's just moving the, you know, previous example that I wrote in a Zeppelin notebook. It's just moving your back-end side code and the front-end side code into the Java application project. And then once you build, and you can Zeppelin provide SDK development model of your application. So instead of you build and package and deploy and run inside of a notebook, you can just run application in your favorite IDE, then your results will immediately displayed on your Zeppelin instance. Okay, and here is how your application will look like. So once you run you have installed your application, and then Zeppelin will automatically suggest your available application based on the context, based on the output from your paragraph. And once you run your application, you will have your application button here, and you can switch between your applications. Okay, if I go back to the slide. So this is a current state of a Helium framework. And the future work is because of we have a pluggable interface for the application. It really makes sense to make an online repository for this all pluggable component, interpreter and notebook storage and Helium applications. And then it also really makes sense to have a registry for this all pluggable components. So Zeppelin user can just go to the registry and search and install that what they want. Yeah, that's it. I think it's a plan about the Helium. And here is a couple of roadmap that Zeppelin community focusing on in this year, I think. One of the items is the Helium that I explained. But the other one is Zeppelin really wanted to be enterprise ready in this year. So last year, I personally get a lot of feedback that Zeppelin is unstable, it's hanging, it's getting error, but I'm kind of a little bit tired of hearing those kind of feedback. So I think Zeppelin will really enterprise ready this year, and to make it enterprise ready, we are working on multi-tenancy and high availability and some enterprise features like job scheduler. And Zeppelin already have authentication and authorization on its master branch, so we are really close to enterprise ready. Another one is usability improvement. It includes UX improvement, and in Zeppelin community, we recently got really nice UX design proposal from UX experts. So we are very excited, and also table data support. Zeppelin have table data display, but it's really basic, so it doesn't support sort, or it doesn't support column level formatting, so we are trying to improve it. And Zeppelin is, because of it's an Apache open source, it's open for everyone, so you can add your plan here. Actually, in our community, we have a roadmap mailing list discussions, so you can participate and you can add your own plan. Okay, so here is some homepage and mailing list address, as well as our source repository. So please visit and please join the community. Okay, thank you. And I really big apologies for this, connectivity issues.